I know that it is much easier for a person to learn a language during childhood. But age is never a barrier to prevent any human being from doing any good work. And that reminds me of the example of Dr. Maurice Bucail. Many of you may be aware that Dr. Maurice Bucail was a very famous surgeon and scientist who was given the French Academy Award in Medicine. And Dr. Maurice Bucail, he was selected for doing research on the mummy of Manapta, that is, the mummy of the body of Pharaoh, who was there at the time of Moses, peace be upon him, which is mentioned in the Bible. And after he did research on this mummy of Manapta, which was found in the Valley of Kings, he being a Christian, he was aware of the background mention of Moses, peace be upon him, in the Bible. And he was aware that the Pharaoh at the time of Moses, peace be upon him, when he followed Moses, peace be upon him, when he parted the sea, and when he followed him, the sea again came back to normal and the Pharaoh had drowned. But when he went to Saudi Arabia, there he learned that the Muslims told him that the Quran already mentions in Surah Yunus, chapter number 10, verse number 92, that Allah says, "We shall save the body of the Pharaoh as a sign for posterity." Dr. Professor Keith Moore, he was shocked that how does this book, the glorious Quran, 1400 years back, says that Almighty God will save the body of Pharaoh as a sign for posterity, as a sign for humankind. And this is not mentioned in the Bible. So that instigated him to read the translation of the Quran. And after he read the translation of the Quran, he was so much inspired that he wanted to understand the Quran better. So at the age of 50, he learned Arabic as a language to understand the Quran better. Imagine a non-Muslim, a Christian, to understand the Quran better, he learns Arabic as a language. And after he does research, he says that the scientific points mentioned in the Quran are in perfect conformity with what modern science has discovered. And unfortunately, there are many things in the Bible which do not conform with modern science. And after doing further research, he writes a book, The Bible, the Quran and Science, which became very famous. The point to be noted here is, imagine a person of the age of 50, being a non-Muslim, being a Christian, to understand the Quran better, he learns Arabic as a language. So we Muslims, the best excuse we have is that we don't know Arabic as a language. I do not expect every Muslim to be as enthusiastic as Dr. Maurice Bucail, that they'd like to learn Arabic at the age of 50. But even if a Muslim does not know Arabic as a language, yet he has got no excuse, because he can yet read the translation of the Quran. And alhamdulillah, the Quran has been translated into most of the major languages of the world. Maulana Abdul Majid Daryabadi says, the Quran is the most untranslatable book in the world. The language of the Quran is so pure. It is divine. It is noble. It is unsurpassable. It is intelligible. And that is the reason it makes Quran the most difficult book to translate. Not only does it make it the most difficult book to translate. In fact, it is a book which is impossible to translate. Yet, alhamdulillah, there are many scholars who have spent several years, who have spent decades in doing research and have translated the glorious Quran into most of the major languages of the world. Even though I agree that no translation is 100% perfect, because a translation is a human handiwork, and the Arabic Quran is the word of Almighty God, the Creator. But in spite of that, these translations, at least they let us understand the basic message of the Quran, the basic message of our Creator Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We Muslims, we give excuses for not reading the translation of the Quran, saying we are very busy. We are very busy in our studies, we are busy in our profession, we are busy in our business. Most of us, we have spent decades reading and memorizing volumes of books in schools and colleges as well as universities just to acquire a degree. Don't we have the time to read the message of our Creator Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? How much time does it take to read the Quran? Our beloved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, it's a Sahih hadith in Tirmidhi, where he said that anyone who reads the Quran in less than 3 days, he has not understood the Quran. That means if we read the Quran with concentration, it will minimum take a person 3 days, minimum. If you read a bit slowly, it may take 3 days. If you read one juz, one part a day, it will take you 1 month to read the Quran. The degree that we acquire in the colleges and universities, it may or may not help you in this world. There are hundreds and thousands of graduates and postgraduates that I know that are jobless. And the education you acquire in school, colleges and universities, if it does not get you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, if it does not get you closer to your Creator, Almighty God, then this education is useless for the hereafter. So the education that you get in the colleges, in the schools, in universities, may or may not help you in this world. And if it does not get you closer to your Creator Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it is useless in the hereafter. But as far as the Quran is concerned, Allah says in the Quran, in Surah Baqarah, chapter number 2, verse number 1 and 2, Alif Lam Mim, Zalikal Kitab La Raib Fi, Hudal Lil Muttaqin. Alif Lam Mim, this is a book without doubt. This is a book of guidance without doubt for those who have taqwa, for those who fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. That means Allah is giving the promise that this book is a book of guidance. And it will surely benefit you in this world as well as the hereafter.